Hello everyone. So in this video tutorial I am going to discuss about that how can we read a particular text from the PDF file and can compare with the specified text that is present on this PDF file. So if you are working with Selenium and you are automating the any web applications, so that then sometimes you need to automate the PDF file and you want to test that the particular things and particular text is available on this PDF file or not. Suppose that you are working on in the banking project. In this banking project you are generating the one banking statement. So on that PDF file you want to verify that the account number and that respective account balance is available on this PDF file for this particular account holder name. So that data should match with our database. So in automation, how can we verify all these requirements? So for that, so these things I'm going to discuss in this video tutorial. Okay, so to read the PDF file in Java, we need two jar files that should be import in our project. So first is Apache PDF box 1.8.1. I'm referring this 1.8.1 because this is a good to read the PDF data, and Apache font box 1.8.1. So I have given the links. From these links you can download this PDF box as well as this font box jar files. So go to your Google and just type Maven repository for font box 1.1. So here you can see this Maven repository font box. So just click on it, the first link, and download the file. Same thing you can do for the PDF box. This is the PDF box, not this one. Go to this Apache PDF box and go down, and you can download the 1.8.1. Just click on this PDF box, Apache PDF box 1.8.1, click on download. So once you downloaded these both jar files, then you have to import these jar files in your project. So in Eclipse I have one project, Java Learning for Selenium. In this project I have one folder that we call the jars. So I have already put all the jar files, the font box and the PDF box. Once you have all these jar files, you just import these jar files in your project. So click on, right click on your project, go to build path and the configure build path. After that you click on the add jar, expand your project, and go to, I have already imported so it's not showing me the jar folder. So once you have, then you can import all the jar in your project. And just click on OK. So you can see that the jar file is added as a library to your project. After that, I'm going to create a class to write the simple code so that we can read the PDF file. So I have already one PDF file that this is the boardingpass.pdf file. So I want that this PNR number should available on this PDF file, and that should match with my database. So I want to verify this text on this PDF file. So as you can see that this is the file. So we have that we know that how can we read a file. So we are having this file class. First file class, you just create an object of this file class and pass the file path till PDF. Pass this as a string, right? Now you need to import the file class java.io package. Okay, after that what you need to do, once you have created an object of the file class, after that you need to read the file input stream. So we have the one another class that we call file input stream. Or we can pass this file class reference variable to this file input stream class. We need to import this file class, so we can, or we have to add this exception. So this class always throw an exception, that class file not found exception. So we can add the throws clause and we can add IO exception. So it's good to add the IO exception. Now we need one more class to read the PDF file that we call that PDF parser. In this PDF parser, you can provide this file input stream reference variable. So you need to import this class. So you always import this class from org.apache.pdfbox.pdf parser, right? Now you need to parse. So you I have one method that we call the parse method. This method, what it will do, it will pass this file input stream. After that, once we have passed this PDF file, then we need to get the pass document. So how can we get this pass document? So again, go parser, then dot get document. We need the pass document that will return the COS document. We need to import this class, right? Once we have the COS document, we can pass this COS document to our PD document. So for that, again we have another class that called PD document. You can pass this COS document then you need to import this class. So always import from Oracle Apache pdfbox.pd model, right? So once we have the PD document, now we can call our one stripper that will strip all the text that is available on this PDF file. So we have one another class to read this PDF text stripper. PDF text stripper class. Once we have the stripper, this class will strip all the text that is available on this PDF. Now we need to get this text. So strip dot, you can call the get text method, right? So get text method from this PD document. You must remember, you should pass the PD document, okay? So it will return a string. So when should they get text, it always return a string data. So I'm going to store string data to this string. Okay. Now you want to check that it's going to fetch the particular data. So I'm just going to print this data, right? Now I am done with this code. I'm just going to run this program and it will fetch all the data that is available on this PDF file. Just right click, run as Java application. Now you can see on my console that it's fetching the all the data that is available on this PDF file, right? Email, boarding pass and everything is there. Now I want to verify this PNR number should be available on this PDF file. This is my requirement. So what is your next task? You have to put the assertion to verify this particular text should be available on this PDF file. So we can use the assert class, assert dot assert true. So we can provide the one boolean condition. So we have the one string data. So what my requirement, this data should contains this string, then it will say pass. So you can pass one string that text found on the PDF file, right? So after that, you just run this program again, right? So text found on the PDF file, it's going to match the PDF text and it's going to point. After all the operations, what you need to do, you just close the COS document because this is the input output operation, so it's good if you can close it after the operation. Again, I'm going to remove this, and again I'll show you how it's working. So it's just very simple. Click on this, it will text found on that PDF file, right? So this is the PNR number, it's going to match this PNR number my test case is going to pass. So this is the my requirement. Okay, so once again, what you need to do, if you have the PDF file already, if you have the PDF file, then you can read this PDF file using the file class, it will convert into the input stream. Then how you to read the input streams, we have another class that will file input stream. Now we need one parser that we call the PDF parser that is available in that Apache PDF box jar files. Now here the font box is internally used by this PDF parser file, right? After that you need this COS documents. Once you have the parse this file, then you need to get the document. So when you get the parse document, it will return to the COS document. COS document is also a class. Okay, then now you want this COS document should be converted into the PD document. So it will convert, we have the PD document class. So in that constructor, you can pass as an argument of the COS document argument, it will return the PD document. So once you have the PD document, we are having the one class that we call PDF text stripper. The PDF text stripper will strip all the text available on this PDF file, and you can get the text. So when you put this method, it will return all the text that is available on this PDF file. It doesn't care about the formatting and all these things, it will just fetch out the text and it will return to you. Now what is your next task? You just put the assertion in your test, it's contained, then the test case will pass, otherwise it will fail. So this is a very common scenario that that interviewer will ask you, that how will you read the PDF file and how will you fetch all these PDF file. Thank you. So in next video, I'm going to show you, if you have the PDF URL instead of having this PDF file, and how can you read that text. I mean to say that in your project, wherever you are having some PDF link, and you are when you are clicking on this link, it going to open a window. After that window, it will open one PDF file. So how to read from the text from that URL of this PDF file, instead of saving this PDF file on our local drive and you are reading the offline PDF data. Okay, thank you.